My name is Joseph Calzaghi. I've been boxing for 10 years. Started boxing when I was 8 years old and went to the gym when I was 9. My father took me down to the boxing club. I had my first fight when I was about 11. My dad bought me a pair of boxing clubs when I was 7 years of age. And, by the time I went to the gym when I was 9, I already knew a bit of boxing. Like, when I went to the gym for the first time, the trainer then, Paul Williams, I couldn't believe that it was my first time I've ever boxed. He thought I'd been doing it before for a few years, so I already had a bit of experience before I actually went to the gym. You gotta sacrifice a lot. Like, I'm training every day. Remember the morning, 6 miles. Training in the afternoon, training in the night, evening. Takes up a lot of time. But I enjoy it, yeah. I go enjoy it. Boxing is a sport. It's just a way of life for me now, these days. Yeah, there's a lot of boys. They just come down for 2 days, find out how hard the train is, and they don't come again. Mm-hmm. Been maybe 300-400 people who've come down in the last couple of years or so, and only about 10-12 stick it. Yeah. You've got to train that very, very hard. It takes a lot of motivation. Obviously it depends on the individual. You know, you're either talented or you're not. The more what kind of apparatus you don't, if you've got the ability, then you're not going to succeed. Concentrate all in my boxing. So about 30-40 hours training every day. I never used to, pretty much care about my schoolwork. And then I went to college for a year, doing a BTEC course. I just hope that my hands get better, keep okay. I'll get to a professional and be good at it. I like to just relax and listen to some music and talk with friends. Maybe about 10 minutes, 15 minutes before I get in the ring, then I like to be alone. Do a bit of shadow boxing and psych myself up. Get my mind off the contest. I don't really like to think about it because I get myself worked up too much. You've got to be in the right frame of mind before you get into the ring. You've got to just think so you've won it. And you've shown that deep mind.
Take it away! You said, I'm fighting now!
I didn't start off very good my first few fights. My first maybe 15 fights, I won about 10 and lost about 5. Before I went for my first British title, my Welsh title, I was quite lazy, I didn't want to train much, but my dad pushed me a lot, thankfully. He pushed me a lot in my earlier fights when I was about 12, 13, I was very fit for my age. That's probably the reason I won. The first British titles. So I trained very hard for my age. as Williams, and that I was getting stronger through the contests and they were getting weaker. So I had excellent stamina when I was younger. And they didn't know that I was. And I made a breakthrough when they won the Welsh title when I was 12. And I went on to win the ABA title, the Shabia title. And I, following you, I'd done the same when the Welsh, and I lost in a split decision in the final of the ABAs. And the following 2 years after that, I won two ABAs again. And an NABC title, and a Gaelic title. So together now I've won about 7 Welsh titles and 4 Brits. Like the day you get into the ring and you don't think you're going to win, that's the time to give it up. You always be in the frame of mind of winning, and that's where I am. Even if I lose, like, all along again, I'll always think positive of coming back and I'll do better next time. Obviously you've got natural ability as well. There's a lot of people who got dedication but just haven't got no ability. Natural ability. Thankfully I think I got. So I got really, I think I got what it takes to do pretty well in professional. All I need now is the right management and a bit of luck now with without the injuries. Championships hopefully now in March. Well, if I go to a quarter final or get a medal, I'll be automatically selected for the Olympic Games next year in Barcelona. A bit of luck now, if I could do well in these championships coming up, I should be on the right road.
What a start. Calzaghe is lifted aloft. I think we all know which way the judges will see that.
Ladies and gentlemen, we go to the scorecard for the winner, who is now WBO Super Middleweight Champion of the World, Joe Calzaghe.
What a moment for Joe Calzaghe.